Best the hour of 8 o'clock. It is no surprise here at WDKX. We are proud of our local talent. I mean, we are probably the only station in Rochester that really bigs up our local talent. Mm-hmm. And when they do well, we like to let people know about it.
Yes, we do.
Good morning, Eloni. How are you today?
Good morning. I'm good. How
you gotta step up to the mic.
Oh, my bad.
Yeah.
You're never afraid of a mic.
Yeah, no, absolutely. You're a pretty good singer, from what I hear.
I dabble a little bit.
To go to Hollywood, dog.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Now, you tried out for the most popular show on television, American Idol.
Mm-hmm.
And where'd you try out at, first of all?
I tried out in Phoenix, Arizona.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. And they picked you to go to Hollywood.
Correct.
Tell us about the experience, about being in the line, how long it was, all that.
Oh, my gosh. It was crazy. Like, basically, when I went to the Glendale Arena to go audition, there was about 8,000 people there,
mm-hmm.
and it was just crazy. They had us in like lines of four, but there was 12 judges, 12 executive producers, and junior producers there.
Yes.
And we had to audition in front of them,
mm-hmm.
and it was just ridiculous. Like, it was like a cattle call, basically.
All right, 329-47, you're up.
No, serious, it was ridiculous.
That first time when you're in front of those judges,
mm-hmm.
how much can you sing? I heard it's like 10 seconds.
It just depends. Like, if they want to hear your voice, they'll let you sing a little bit more. And
okay.
even they were letting people sing second songs as well to
right.
get, you know, different variety of different styles and whatnot. So,
mm-hmm.
But, I mean, it went pretty quick. But then they had different producers come through. You know, if they thought they may have wanted you, then they'd have another
mm-hmm.
person come and listen to you
okay.
just to make sure. And then they send you through. So,
got it.
Mm-hmm.
So before you get to the four judges, what we see on TV, you've got to see like 12 judges before that.
Pretty much, yes.
Wow.
And
wow.
then all the executive producers, all the junior producers, just to make sure that they even want you on camera.
Mm-hmm.
Period. So
mm-hmm.
It was just crazy.
Then you go into the room with how many people? It's Paula, Simon, they got the new chick.
Kara DeGuardi?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I was going
yeah,
to say.
Yeah, I don't know
mm-hmm.
who she is either.
Yeah. And then Randy.
Randy, yeah.
So mm-hmm. you're in there. Before the four of them, how was that, the moments before, and then when you walk into the room?
It was like an unreal experience. You walk in, and the room is completely lit up, so, you know, and then you see them, and they, like, look flawless. It almost looks like they're just imaginary.
Yeah,
they're not
yeah.
even there. But it was very nerve-wracking, but at the same time, you know, you just got to go in there and give it your all, regardless, so.
And what did you sing?
I sang Sweet Thing, and then I sang American Boy. They wanted to hear two songs.
Oh,
okay.
wow.
Still, so.
There you go.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Now when you're going, did you meet Seacrest?
Yes, I did.
All right, what is he like?
He's really cool, actually.
Oh, really?
He's very handsome.
You know us. Oh, ho, ho.
We might have to make that happen. I know.
It's like, Seacrest, you need to get
that
to
But I want to know about Simon. Was Simon nice or mean?
Actually, you know what? He just keeps it real.
Yeah.
I can't say he was nice or mean. He just tells it like it is, period.
Exactly.
So, and
mm-hmm.
I respect
good.
That. So, mm-hmm.
yeah.
Now, when they're pondering over, after you've sung your two songs, when they're pondering over and they're looking at you, like, as you said, like cattle, like,
mm-hmm.
what is going through your mind at that time? Because that is a nerve. I mean, here you are, you know, it's the moment you sing in front of the four people that may determine whether or not you make this
right.
huge trip.
Mm-hmm.
What's going through your mind as Randy's sitting there like,
I was ready to pass out, to be honest with you.
I like you. I like you. You know.
I had to hold my ground there, but I was ready to pass out. It was, I was so nervous. It was ridiculous. But, I mean, just what was going through my head, I just wanted to go. I just wanted everybody to say yes,
mm-hmm.
and they all said yes. So I didn't get one no or anything like that. So
wow.
They didn't
wow.
actually show my audition, though, on the show because Paula wasn't there.
Oh,
yeah, she
okay.
came in late.
What was going on with her? Can you tell me?
She probably just didn't wake up. I have no
clue. How early was your audition?
Actually, it was about 1 o'clock, but I was there at 7:30 in the morning, and then
yeah.
I didn't leave until about 5.
I could see that with
yeah.
Paula, though. We've
yeah.
seen her interview. She's a little, I know you can't say anything, but I can't.
Trust
she
me.
She's a little cuckoo from people.
I'm not, let's put it to you this way, Eloni. I'm not surprised.
You saw that interview she did? What was it? It was out west somewhere.
Yeah, well, she was in Seattle, and she was like on,
saying
I don't know.
She said she wasn't drunk, and
mm-hmm.
that she wasn't drugged up, that she was just sleep deprived.
Okay.
Now, I've been sleep deprived before.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's not it.
And then, listen, she's done millions
yes.
of interviews. You know when you shouldn't do an interview. Let's put it to you that way.
She was awesome.
I know there's a lot of people may be asking, how come you don't ask this? How come you don't ask that? There's a lot you can't talk about, Eloni. So I'm not going to even try and guilt you into saying anything because I don't want to get you in trouble. But can you talk about the wackos standing in line?
Oh, my gosh. Just like all these people had, like, there's this one guy named Twan. Did you see the guy with the big old humongous fro?
Yes, I didn't get to see his little performance, but I did see him
he
in the
preview. He was tap dancing and everything like that. He had people in line picking his hair for him. It was ridiculous.
That sounds like a
coon. He was very
bad. I can't support it. Sounds like Aaron Magruder needs to meet him and have a, you know, sit down talk.
We have Barbie dolls come out. I mean, oh gosh.
But they have to know that stuff never works. Those people that do that never get there.
They just want to get on TV. They just want to be the dummy that says, hey, you know, look at my Facebook. I got an idol. Ooh. Well, you know, that's what they want to do.
Well, like one person in specific, the bikini girl. I can't remember her name, but like everybody, she got so much airtime and press just because she wore a bikini. It was ridiculous. But
that's what it's about for some of them. Mm-hmm. That's what it's about.
But I mean, if that's what she came to accomplish, she did a very
good
job.
Yeah, people are going to forget about that. I mean, that's literally not even 15 minutes. You're going to get 15 seconds after that.
Yeah, there's so many other questions I want to ask, but I'm trying to artfully go around it so you don't get in trouble.
So prior to American Idol, what were you doing? How about that?
I've actually been doing a lot of studio work. I also gig on the weekends. I've been working with one of Dr. Dre's producers. His name is Che Vicious. And also been working with a local producer. His name is Irot. But he has an album out called Rocka is a Classic. Mm-hmm. And I'm all over the album. Mm-hmm. It's actually like number 17 on iTunes right now.
Well, I tell you what, we are very proud to have you on the air.
We didn't say who she belongs to.
Who does she belong to? What?
Miss LD.
Oh yeah, this is right.
You can say that.
This
right?
is right.
Yeah,
I thought people knew that from the previous interviews we've done, but you're right. People may not know that. Miss LD and
Shuma. Come on here looking just like her.
And y'all jumped in the water?
Yes, we did. It was like 110 degrees outside. It was too hot. My hair was all sweating out.
Let me just tell you, that's one of those mother daughter bonding moments you'll love for the rest of your life. And everybody will always remember. That is. Well, I tell you what, your mom is extremely proud of you. We are as well here in Rochester. We wish you all the best of luck the rest of the way through.
I love you, Rochester. I miss you guys.
All right, 103.9 Interactive.
It's cold as Sephora.
We got a few.
Put it in Arizona now. Like, I miss you.
It's
83
yesterday.
83?
What?
83 degrees in Phoenix yesterday.
Well, we got a 3 in here somewhere.
Yeah, that's
about
it. Trying
to get some warmth here.
Usually it's surrounded by a 1 or a 2. That's about it. WDKX to the Wake Up Club, LL Cool J, I Need Love. Good morning.